Dear students, now let us see our chapter number 13, direct and inverse proportion. To understand this, first you will understand what is ratio. Ratio you have learned already. That combination of two quantities of smaller kind with the help of division. Means, suppose we divide the quantities and we are getting one ratio, that is called the ratio of that quantities. What is proportion? Proportion, proportion when two ratios are equal, they say to be in proportion. In proportion, we can see two type of proportion, direct proportion and inverse proportion. What is direct proportion? Just right now you understand this x1 upon y1 is equal to x2 upon y2. That means the same quantities x and x1 and x2, related quantities y and y2, the ratio of that are same. Suppose we see that one car is within 20 minutes, it covers 20 kilometers. So 20 by 20, so y is 20 kilometers and x is 20 minutes. And another car covers 40 minutes, within 40 minutes, 40 kilometers. That means 20 by 20 is equal to 40 by 40. So we can say that the ratio is in direct proportion. Suppose this way we can see the ratio is called direct proportion. In this example also we will see here inverse proportion. What is inverse proportion? Sometimes corresponding quantities are increasing. One quantity is increasing and second quantity is decreasing. Like that. Like mobile's price. Suppose whatever mobile is of 10,000 right now in this month. But after 6 months, the price of this same mobile will be decreased. So this way, sometimes as time is the price is decreasing. So this way some quantities will be like on increasing one type of quantity, related quantity will be decreased. And for another also the same. So at a time we will say that inverse proportion, and for to calculate inverse proportion, we will use x1 by y2 is equal to x2 by y1. If we take cross multiplication, x1 y1 is equal to x2 y2. So we can remember this easily. So remember this for direct proportion and this for inverse proportion. Now let us see question number 1 of exercise 13.1. They want to ask that check this, whether this all the matters are in direct proposal or not. For and for ratio, let us take 4 by 60. 4 by 60 is or 60 by 4. You can do that also. 4 by 60 also. So 15. 1 upon 15. Now 8 by 100. So 8 by 100, that is 2. 4 2s are 8 and 25 4s are 15. You can see that these ratios are not same. And same way 12 by 140 and 24 by 180, and this will result 2 by 6 2s are 35, and for this you will get 2 12 2s are 24 and 15s are. So here you can see that these all ratios are not equal. So this quantity is not in direct proportion. Now let us see this question number 2. In this question number 2, it is given that this quantity is in direct proportion. That means if we take ratio 1 upon 8, so part of base is 8 and part of red pigment is 1. So if 1 is there, then base is 8. Then what will be the 4? Then what will be the part of base? For calculating this, we will use this y2. Here x1 is 1 upon y1 is 8 is equal to x2 is 4 and divided by y2 is y2 we need to 1. Now here you can see that 1 4s are 4. So 8 4s are, we will multiply with 4. And we will here if we multiply with 4 then we are getting 4. So 8 4s are 32. So y2 is equal to 32. Same way. In this 7, 1 into 7 is equal to 7. So 8 into 7 is equal to 56. So here we will write 56. Same way. 1 into 12 is equal to 12. So here 8 into 12 is equal to 96. So here we will get 96. Same way, 20 into 8. 20 into 8 is 160. So this way you can find out this another quantities also with the help of this formula x1 upon y1 is equal to x2 upon y2, which is the formula for direct proportion. Now let us see question number 3. A part of a red pigment, which is from question number 2 only. In question number 2, one part of red pigment requires 75 ml of base. And how much part should be mixed with 18,000? Means here, x1 is 1. Then we can say that y1 is 75 ml. And if y x2, what will be the part? For y2 is equal to 1800 ml. So here this is direct proportion. So we will write this way: x1 upon y1 is equal to x2 upon y2. That means x1 is 1 upon 75 is equal to x2 divided by 1800. Now let us take cross multiplication. Then 75 x2 is equal to 1800. Therefore, x2 is equal to 1800 divided by 75. And calculating x2 is equal to 24 will be there. 75 is up. Okay. Now in question number 4. Number of hours. X is equal to 6 and 5. So number of waters filled is equal to 840. And how much, what is the number of bottles to fill in 5 hours? Here hours are reduced, then bottles may be reduced. So x1 is equal to 6, y1 is equal to 840, x2 is equal to 5, and y2 is equal to, we have to find out. So x1 upon y1 is equal to x2 upon y2. Therefore 6 by 840 is equal to 5 by y2. Now let us take cross multiplication here again. Then 6 y2 is equal to 5 into 840. Therefore y2 is equal to 5 into 840 divided by 6. If we calculate it, y2 is equal to 6, then we will get 700. You can calculate yourself and write it. So this way you can complete your remaining question from exercise 13.1. All another questions are same. You have to make this type of table with the help of given matters, and then you have to find out, you have to decide what is x1, what is y1, and what is x2, and what is y2, and then you can use this formula and directly you can find out easily.